Hello, what are you reading?
Hi, it's the Holy Quran.
But isn't the Quran only for Muslims?
Not at all. Its teachings are addressed to all humanity, from heads of state to everyday people like us.
What does it teach us?
It's a book of life for life. No thinking person should pass through life without it.
Where can I get a copy?
From the IPCI, 124 Queen Street, Durban.
خلق فسوى والصلاة والسلام على حبيبه المصطفى أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ونزلنا عليك الكتاب تبيانا لكل شيء وهدى ورحمة وبشرى للمسلمين صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين My respected elders in Islam Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are very fortunate and privileged to have with us this afternoon, or rather it's still morning, afternoon, a very prominent, dynamic, intellectual, a scientist, and being all that, still considers himself to be a humble servant of Allah and His Rasul, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I am referring to Dr. Zakir Abdul Karim Naik, who is the Secretary General of the Islamic Research Foundation, which he worked tirelessly to establish in Bombay, in India. Their mission is to defend Islam and to promote Islam in a pragmatic way, in a scientific way, applying logic and reason. I had the privilege and honor of listening to two or three of his lectures on video, and I must say and admit that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon him his blessing, his rahmah. He has given this brother great wisdom, and he has made an in-depth study, it seems, of the Holy Quran. Not only the Holy Quran, but all Semitic religions. I am talking about Judaism, Christianity and Islam, as well as the Hindu scriptures, the Vedas, etc. And he is also a scholar of comparative religious studies. Being a doctor by profession, he had this love and yearning for Islamic learning, and the concern of the Ummah and the mustaqbil of this Ummah that brought him towards Deen, towards studying of the Deen and promoting the Deen. He is a very humble brother. His achievements, if you see him, you cannot imagine his achievements. I have seen his achievements in two or three of his tapes, and I think that he is the hope of the future generation and youth of India of tomorrow. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him success in all his endeavors. He belongs also to a family of very highly professional people. His father is also here with us this afternoon. He is Dr. Abdul Karim Naik. Looking at him and looking at his qualifications, now I can understand why he has produced such a highly intellectual and dedicated son. Looking at him, because he is a practical person and a very knowledgeable person himself, and that is what has rubbed on with his children. And alhamdulillah, Dr. Naik, Zakir Naik, and his brother Dr. Muhammad are serving Islam in Hindustan, in India. And I pray, and I hope all of us pray, that Allah grant him success. Now it is my privilege and great honor to call upon this very dynamic scholar who is self-schooled and self-taught, whom Allah has given so much, and I envy him. I envy him, I am allowed to envy him, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and Hazrat Abdullah ibn Masud said, they are reported by him, he said that you can envy someone in two cases, in two instances. One, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given so much of wealth and dawlat and maal, and he has also empowered him to spend it on righteousness, on good way, in a good way. And one who has, Allah has given so much of intellect, wisdom and knowledge, and he practices it and teaches it. So I envy him in that sense. May Allah allow him to grow and grow from strength to strength. I call upon Dr. Zakir A. Naik to address the subject of Islamic dietary laws and what is the scientific basis. Janab Zakir A. Naik, tashrif lain.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حرمت عليكم الميتة والدم ولحم الخنزير وما أهل لغير الله به بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. My dear brothers in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, blessings, and mercy of Almighty Allah be on all of you. The topic for today's pre-Khutbah talk is the scientific reasons for the dietary laws in Islam. According to the Islamic law, few